Hey there, I'm Diana, and welcome to How to HubSpot. Last week, I uncovered three ways to master lead generation in HubSpot using landing pages, forms, and ads. So today, I'm going to walk you through what I learned. And if you're not a HubSpot user, don't worry, we've got you covered. You can get started for free with our powerful marketing hub using the link in the description below. Let's get into it. The most important rules to follow are give before you get and add value every step of the way. So let's focus on that first rule and use lead magnets. Lead magnets are tools that add value for your visitors in exchange for their contact info. So if you're a new business owner, an entrepreneur, you might use an email opt-in subscription or social media follows as a sign of interest from people who find you on the internet. The goal is to ultimately receive permission from visitors to follow up. Some examples could be a training video series, a free trial, webinars, ebooks, or bonus tips. These free educational tools will get your visitors to trust you and as a result, share their email address with you. So next month, I'll be speaking at one of our HubSpot user groups in Frisco, Texas. The series is called Grow with the Flow, and I want to invite entrepreneurs, new business owners, Hub fans, and any HubSpot users out there interested in learning about the basics of automation. The event is free, and I want to get as many people as possible to register for it. So today, we'll build a landing page for that. Let's jump into HubSpot's Content Hub. In the main menu, select Content, Landing Pages. In the top right, click Create, then select Landing Page. I'm gonna start with LP to make sure I remember it's a landing page, and I'm gonna call it Grow with the Flow. I'll hit Create, and this will take me straight to our template marketplace. I really love this part of the tool because you can select different types of templates that might work for what you're trying to do. In this case, I love the Academia templates. They are absolutely free. You can also pay for templates if you'd like, but we're gonna go free this time. So I am going to look for a landing page that invites someone to a webinar. So this one looks appealing to me, join our workshop to learn something new. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit select. This will take me to our workspace. And as you can see, there's a really nice header here. There's a compelling title, join our workshop to learn something new. I kind of like that. It says register now, so it's clear that this is a landing page. As we scroll down, you're gonna see that at the top of the fold, there's a little bit of copy here. In this case, it's a contact us copy, but I'm gonna change that. And I'm actually going to change this to RSVP now. So right within the tool, you can go into RSVP. At the bottom, copy that I'll include is join our HubSpot user group. And for my compelling copy, I'll probably say something like join our automation workshop masterclass to learn how to automate your sales process. And of course, you can think about how you want to change and make this, you know, compelling to your audience, but you can also use AI here and hit rewrite and ask AI to rewrite this for you and make it sound better. Now, the other piece that I want you to note here is there is two columns here in the table. It's a very simple design and it's at the top of the fold. So we want to make sure people are not navigating away from your landing page and that they know exactly what you're asking of them. We're gonna go back to that first rule where we always give before we get. And that means we are going to give them a valuable workshop for free that they can access. And we're only gonna ask them for two things, their first name, maybe their last name, and their email address. So this is where we build the form. Right within the landing page builder, you can give your form a title, and I'm going to just label it Grow with the Flow. And what I also really like about this is you can build a ton of different forms depending on what type of content offer you're putting out into the world. So in this case, it's a free webinar. I don't want to ask too much of them. So I'm just going to build my own form here and I'm going to call it Grow with the Flow Register Now. So another thing you can see here is that your form content includes a thank you note. This is one of the things that I really love about the tool too, because there's an option to write an inline thank you message, like thank you for registering to our webinar. You'll receive a confirmation email shortly. This is a great way to just let the person know that, hey, I got you, you're all set. I will send you an email so that you don't forget to join the webinar when it's time. As you navigate through building your landing page, you'll also notice there's an option to automate the form. And you can actually select always create a new contact for email addresses. And that means every time a person signs up to your webinar or signs up to subscribe to your blog or any other content offer on your website, you will create a new contact in your CRM to record their information. You can also follow up with an email and immediately select an email right from the landing page builder. You don't even have to navigate outside to go to your marketing and pick the email. You can just select the email right here. And in this case, I will show you exactly how to build one. I've already built one here, Grow with the Flow series. We're gonna walk through step by step to make sure you know how to do that very easily within the tool. As we drop down to the landing page, you'll see there's an opportunity to include a video, a compelling image, and maybe even some more copy on what are the topics that will be discussed at the event. I really like the idea of including testimonials. So perhaps at the bottom, I'll include a bit of testimonials, information about what others have said about the HubSpot user group. So it's very simple to just delete this module, go into the plus sign and add an image. So I'm gonna look for the image here under design. I'm gonna ask it to show more. Great, so it's gonna be this image here. I'm gonna drag and drop it. And what you can do is replace the image straight from your HubSpot tool. You'll find any images that you recently uploaded. So in this case, I'm going to select a testimonial from someone that attended a previous hug. And this shows, you know, there's a reason why someone would want to join your HubSpot user group. Now, I'm going to show you what the preview looks like now for this rough draft. There's your compelling heading here at the top. You have some copy about joining the HubSpot user group and the form. We built this really fast, but I've actually built one out for you to see what the final product looks like. So I'm gonna show it to you. I'm gonna go right into Content Hub and show you that landing page straight here. So once you've taken some time to think through the design, you can change it up and it'll look something like this. And I'm actually gonna show you what it looks like when somebody submits their information. So let's say I sign up for this webinar, I give you my first name, last name, and email, and I say RSVP to join with my compelling CTA, I will be able to sign up immediately right from within this page and receive that inline thank you note. Now let's navigate to the left side of the landing page builder. This plus sign, as we saw, is where you can add different modules, different sections, and different layouts. So if you want to, instead of having two columns, just have one single column, you can do that very easily from this page. Under the Contents tab, you can see all of your page contents. This makes it really easy for you to navigate what you're doing within your landing page, and you can simplify it by looking at visibility, the alignment, and the spacing, and then you can go into the background. The other tab here is the Optimize tab. This is just, I mean, so cool. There is an option to give you recommendations for SEO, even if you don't know exactly if your page is performing the way that it should. You can add a meta description and include the topic phrase in the page to help visitors and search engines understand what your page is about. You can add a word that makes it easy for Google to find your landing page. So in this case, automation is the keyword, and I'm gonna make sure that there is somewhere in this landing page the word automation. Once you've optimized your landing page, all of these red numbers should turn into green check marks, and that will be an indication that you are done optimizing your landing page and you're ready to publish it. The tab for test here is another really fun way to test your landing page for different audiences. So in this case, I can run an A/B test where my page traffic will be split 50-50 between two page variations that I choose. And in this case, I'll pick an audience from my LinkedIn network and an audience from my social media accounts. They're probably gonna act differently or behave differently as they navigate my landing page, so I'll run a test for them. I can then see how the landing page is performed and select the one that works best. The last tab here is a site navigator. This is just a really great way to keep you organized. So if you're like me and you can get lost in the weeds a little bit, having this site navigator will just keep you organized and not getting lost between your landing pages and your thank you pages. You can also directly link your blog here and your blog listing pages so that if you have any blogs that you want to connect to your landing page, you can do that as well. All right, so let's take a look at what this looks like. We will hit preview, and we can even view or preview this page as a specific contact, and we can select whoever's email it is. If we personalize a landing page for Leslie in this case, then the landing page will show up for her specifically. And you can do a ton of other fun stuff with smart content to personalize landing pages for your audience. Cool, so now that we've built this landing page, the next step is to follow up. We want to make sure that folks that have registered to your webinar are receiving a follow-up email. So our follow-up is a really great way to remind them of the event, make sure that they add it to their calendar, and at the same time, maybe even ask them to follow you on social. So I'll show you how to build that follow-up email. We're gonna exit here and go into marketing and hit email. From the email tab, we're gonna go create email. And in this case, we're gonna pick automated. Why? The reason is we wanna make sure that this email is part of a workflow. A workflow in HubSpot means you're gonna pick a specific trigger that will make it so that somebody receives an email off of an action. So if somebody clicks a link or a CTA, then an email will automatically be sent to them. You need to make sure that this is selected when you create the email so that you can build a workflow. Now, similar to how we built the landing page, you can select a template and it can be a drag and drop type template. You can look at any number of templates here, whether it be a newsletter, an announcement, an ebook. In this case, it's an event invitation. And I actually really like this one. So I'm gonna select this one and start building it out. As you can see, again, there's a compelling header at the top. So we can start with something like you're registered to attend the Frisco Hug. And I like what this says, learn from the best in the business, so I will leave it there. Here, you can also just write some compelling copy like at Grow with the Flow series. You'll get a full day, because it's not four full days, it's a full day to connect with fellow marketing professionals and entrepreneurs. That's true, I'm gonna leave it there. Learn from experts during our many breakout sessions, take part in hands-on workshops, and get inspired by keynote sessions from marketing experts and industry leaders. I really love that. Now we're adding a reminder of where the event is, so you can add in the address, information on how people should get there, and absolutely adding when this will be. This will be happening on August 13th at 11 a.m. Central. And at the bottom, just some detail on the speaker. So if somebody that has registered to your webinar wants to learn more about the speakers, you can add a CTA for them to click into read more about them. And lastly, I'm going to change this button here to join now instead of register now, because the person has already registered to your event. They're just going to click on this button to take them directly to the webinar. And with that, we can preview our follow-up email. And there you have it. This is what it'll look like on your desktop, and this is what it'll look like on mobile. We went through creating your landing page, creating a follow-up email, and now we actually need to get traffic to that landing page. So one of the really cool things you can also do with HubSpot is connect your ads, and you can build ads directly from within HubSpot. In this case, I'm going to connect my LinkedIn account. How does that work in HubSpot? You can get started with the HubSpot Ads tool and start by navigating to the marketing tool, hit Ads, and this will take you through a connection flow. You can connect your social media accounts like Facebook, Instagram, your Twitter accounts, and you can even connect LinkedIn. In this case, I'm going to be using my LinkedIn audience, so I will go into marketing, social, and I've already connected my LinkedIn account. So I'll hit Create Social Posts, and this is where I can get creative and say, join me for the Grow with the Flow series in Frisco, Texas, to learn more about how you can automate your sales process. And I'll add some detail on when it's happening, August 13th, 11 a.m. And I'll say, join here or register here. Now, the cool thing is I can also select this and make it better using the AI assistant and rewrite that. I really enjoy the fact that I don't have to take much longer when I create a LinkedIn post. And so this rewrote it for me, and it sounds pretty good to me. And I will add in the link and post it. I can also add media here and select publishing options to publish it now or schedule for later. I can then go ahead and hit schedule, and this will post it for me directly from my HubSpot account. For now, I'm just gonna save the draft and exit out. So now that I've connected my social accounts, let's imagine that 100 people RSVP'd to the Frisco Hug. I highly recommend using HubSpot's CRM to give your leads a home. It helps unify your customer profiles, your teams, and your tech stack, and it provides a more comprehensive view of your contacts. Let's take a peek at a contact record in the HubSpot CRM. I'm gonna hit CRM here and go straight to contacts. I'm gonna select myself because I've signed up for my webinar, and I can see what pages I've viewed, how long I've spent on each page. There's even information on if there's a page that I return to more than once. Now, if you're starting to create more content, see more traffic on your site, and growing your business, keeping an online presence is so important. Let's access the analytics report in HubSpot and customize a report to fit your business needs. So within HubSpot, you can go into reporting and get very detailed on the analytics of your entire website. But for this video, I'll show you some analytics based on the campaign we just built. So in this case, I want to analyze how the Grow with the Flow series email performed. Now, of course, I haven't sent this email yet, so there isn't any data to show, but I'll explain what it will look like once you actually send this email. There are three tabs here. You can see performance, you can see the recipients, so who this email was sent to, and the different time zones that received the email. Let's check performance. There are three key metrics here that matter: the open rate, the click rate, and the reply rate. This makes it really easy for you to know if the open rate is really good or if it's terrible and you have to change the way that you're sending emails or the copy in your emails. As you scroll down, you'll be able to see delivery and revenue attribution. Delivery is one of the most critical pieces. You want to ensure that anybody who is receiving an email or is in the list to receive an email gets the email, and that there aren't any bounces, unsubscribes, or spam reports. If that's happening, you need to make sure that you're checking your email deliverability scores. Revenue attribution will connect anything that you did, specifically a webinar, that led to revenue or to a deal closing. This will show right here. And lastly, you have an HTML click map and your top click links, as well as your top engaged contacts. I really like that you can see how your email performs here and the heat map where somebody would click on a CTA in your email and where specifically people are spending their time. I think you're ready to master lead generation and watch your business grow. But don't forget, to become a lead generation pro, you need the right tools to make it happen. You can get started for free with our powerful marketing hub using the link in the description below. Thanks for joining me. I'm Diana, and don't forget to comment on what tools you'd like to learn about next. See you next time.